Hello dear students, welcome to Karim's Biology. So in class 8 biology we are discussing the lesson what is science, and today will be part 6, and in this session we are going to learn about what are variables. It's a very simple concept and I am going to explain about this concept by taking a small example. Okay children, so let's enter into the topic.
Subscribe now and press the bell icon. Never miss an update.
Today's concept also is related to process skills, but at the end of the concept I am going to make it clear for you the meaning of variables, okay, and what are variables, how the variables can be controlled, what is the effect of variables at the output of the result. Everything we are going to discuss in this session. Okay, first of all let us discuss about the process skills. There are another set of process skills that we can use while conducting any experiment. What is that? First step is hypothesis. Second step in the process skills is plan and conduct experiment. And the third step in this process skill is controlling the variables. This is what we are going to focus upon. Okay children, and we will be discussing about this with the help of a small example. This is the experiment conducted by a girl by name Sweta. And Sweta wants to investigate. What Sweta wants to know? She wants to know which fabric material absorbs more water. So this was the question in the mind of Sweta that she has been thinking of so many days, and today she wanted to confirm what material, which type of fabric material absorbs more water and which fabric material absorbs less water. And let us find out how she is going to do that. Okay children, and to do that she will follow the same steps that we have just now discussed. Okay, which set of process skills she is going to use? She is going to use these three set of process skills, which include the hypothesis, planning and conducting experiment, and controlling the variables. So in the first step, she plans a test to find out how much water different fabric materials absorb. She actually wants to make a comparison between two different types of fabrics. One is cotton fabric and other one is synthetic fabric. So she wants to find out among cotton fabric and synthetic fabric which one is going to absorb more water and which fabric is going to absorb less water by using a set of process skills called hypothesize, plan and conduct experiment, and controlling the variables. Okay children, let us find out what and how this girl performs the experiment. In the first step of her process skills, she chooses two equal sized cloth pieces having the length of 30 centimeters and breadth of 30 centimeters. Okay, as she wanted to know about cotton and synthetic fabrics, she selected cotton fabric and synthetic fabric, but she has to make sure that both fabric pieces should have same length and same breadth. Okay, so this is one of the variable that this girl has to control. If Sweta takes cotton fabric of 30 into 30 and synthetic fabric of 40 into 30, then there is a difference in the diameter, right? When there is a difference in this, there will be no accurate result that she will be getting. Okay, so in order to get accurate result, she must make sure that both cotton fabric and synthetic fabric should have same length and the same breadth. Okay, so that's one of the first variable that she has to control, because if there is any difference in the length and breadth of two fabrics, the result that she is going to get will be a wrong result. As a result, interpretation will be wrong and the entire experiment will be a failure. Okay, so that's why it is the first variable that she has to make sure that both the fabrics should have equal size, right? And what is the second step? In second step, she made a hypothesis. Okay, you know that in experimental procedure, before conducting experiment, we make hypothesis. Hypothesis means just making a guess. Now she made a guess, she made an hypothesis that cotton fabric absorbs more water. So what was the hypothesis? Cotton fabric absorbs more water than synthetic fabric. So this was the hypothesis made by Sweta. Now she has to check the hypothesis by conducting a small experiment. Okay children, now did you understand? And the cotton fabric had 30 into 30 size and synthetic fabric should also 30 into 30 centimeters in its size. Both must be equal, right? Now what is the next step? In the next step, she plans and conducts an experiment to test. Now she has to test her hypothesis. Now let us find out what is the procedure that this girl has followed to test her hypothesis. In the first step, she has taken two glass beakers and pour 100 ml of water into each of the two beakers. So what she did in the first step? In first step, this girl has taken two glass beakers, right? So these are the two glass beakers, and each glass beaker should be filled with 100 ml of water. So this is the second variable that this girl has to control. Okay, both beakers should have equal amount of water. How much water? 100 ml of water. Now you can see this beaker consists of 100 ml of water, and this beaker 2 consists of 100 ml of water. So there is no doubt that both beakers are now having filled with same amount of water, that is 100 ml of water. In the next step, put the two fabrics in two different beakers for 10 seconds. So this step is very important step. So there comes the third variable. What was the first variable that she controlled? Size of the two fabrics. Okay, both of them should be equal size. And the second variable that she has to make sure is amount of water in the beakers. Both beakers should have 100 ml of water. Now here comes the third variable that she has to make sure of. And what is the third variable? Two fabric pieces, they should be first of all folded properly. Okay, they should be first of all folded properly, and what should be done? They have to be kept in the beakers filled with water. That means these two fabrics should be dipped in the water for how much time? For exactly 10 seconds, not more than 10 or not less than 10. And remember children, it is very important for this girl to make sure both cotton fabric and synthetic fabric should be kept in water exactly for 10 seconds. Okay, if the girl puts this cotton fabric in the water for 20 seconds and synthetic fabric is kept in the water for 30 seconds, now that is of no use because she will be getting a wrong result, isn't it? That's why I told you that this time factor is the third variable that she has to control. She has to make sure that both fabrics should be dipped in water and kept in water for exactly 10 seconds. Okay, we are going to dip these two fabrics after folding them in these beakers filled with water, right? So after completion of 10 seconds, the fabric pieces should be pulled off and they should be allowed to drain for exactly 5 seconds. Yes, now we have completed the steps. After completing the steps, now we have to measure the amount of water left in each beaker. Okay, children, I think that you have guessed by this time that when she placed the cotton fabric in the beaker containing water, the cotton fabric would have absorbed some water, right? And when we removed the cotton fabric from the water, along with the fabric, some amount of water also has been removed from the beaker, right? And the same thing happens with the synthetic fabric. When you kept the synthetic fabric in the water, the fabric would have absorbed some amount of water, and when you take it out of the beaker along with that synthetic fabric, some amount of water might have been removed from the beaker, right? Now our duty is to measure how much amount of water is left in each beaker. Now can you see the level of this water in these two beakers? I think that if you look at it, there is a small difference. Now let us find out what that girl absorbed in the level of water. The amount of water in beaker A is 65 ml. So this is beaker A. First beaker is the beaker A. And what is the amount of water in that? 65 ml of water was there. And how much water was there previously before we dip the cotton cloth in that? Before that it was 100 ml. Right? Now it is only 65 ml. Then what happened to the remaining amount of water? Okay, let us see. And whereas the second beaker, beaker B, it is beaker B. How much amount of water is there in beaker B? 85 ml of water is left in beaker B. Okay, so how can we calculate that? In beaker A, initially there was 100 ml of water. Okay, and after completion of experiment, that is after you dip the cotton cloth, because remember, in beaker A, we have kept the cotton fabric, right? So after putting the cotton fabric, after cotton has absorbed the water, how much water is left? 65 ml of water is left. Okay, so if you subtract 100 out of 65, how much you will get? 35 ml. Okay, so this 35 ml has been removed from the beaker. How it has been removed? That means that 35 ml of water has been absorbed by the cotton fabric. Whereas in beaker B, 100 ml of water was there previously. But when we placed the synthetic fabric in beaker B, after we remove that after 10 seconds, how much water was left in that? 85 ml of water is left. That means 100 minus 85, 15 ml of water has been removed from the beaker. I think that water was absorbed by the synthetic fabric. Okay, so basing on that, what is the conclusion that you give? Cotton fabric has absorbed 35 ml of water and synthetic fabric has absorbed 15 ml of water. Tell me which fabric has absorbed more amount of water. Yes, cotton fabric has absorbed more water than the synthetic fabric, because cotton fabric absorbed 35 ml, synthetic fabric absorbed only 15 ml of water. And what was the hypothesis made by this girl? She made a hypothesis that cotton fabric absorbs more water, and the hypothesis that she has made became true now, right? So this is how she had used the process skills. Okay, once again, let's now find out what are variables. I have also told you that if there is no proper care taken about variables, the entire experiment will be spoiled and the result that you may get will be a wrong result. Okay, what is the first variable that we have seen? Size of fabric pieces, right? Both fabric pieces should be of equal size. And other one, amount of water in the beakers. I told you both beakers should have 100 ml of water. And the third variable that she has to control is time duration. I told you that when she places the fabrics in the water, she has to keep the fabrics in the water for exactly 10 seconds. After 10 seconds, she can remove the fabrics from the beaker. Then after removing, she has to keep the fabrics there itself to drain excessive water for exactly 5 seconds. There should not be any difference in the time. Right, so that is the other variable. So children, these are about variables and also other set of process skills. I hope that you understood. In my next session, I will explain about steps in reading. Okay children, that's all for today. I will meet you in my next session. Thank you.